Our whole universe was in a hot, dense state. Then nearly 14 billion years ago, expansion started. Wait, the Earth began to cool. The autotrophs began to drool. Neanderthals developed tools. We built a wall.
We built the pyramids. Math,
science, history, unraveling the mystery that all started with a Big Bang.
Is this all really a coincidence? Imagine going into a jungle in the middle of nowhere where there's been no humans before. And in the middle of this jungle, you see a brand new Ferrari. So you think to yourself, I want to analyze how this Ferrari got here and what is it here for. So you open the door, you see that there is a seat. It's as though it's designed for you to sit inside of it, leather comforting. So you sit inside, you hold the steering, and you realize that the steering has been designed for your hands, perfectly placed. There is a windscreen, and it's made from glass. It was made so that you can see through it. So it was designed for someone that has eyes. Then you look at the pedals on the floor. They are designed exactly for your feet. And you see that there is a switch that controls the window with your finger. You press the button and the window goes down. So what was it designed for? Who was it designed for? And that's the question. It's definitely not designed for an elephant. It'll just crush the car. It's not designed for a giraffe. A giraffe's too big to even get in. Or a little bug. Or any other creature that's in the middle of the jungle. It wasn't designed for them. You look at all the other features in the car and then you realize it was perfectly made for your fingers, for your eyes, for your hands and feet. It was designed specifically for you. Now the question arises. Where did this car come from? Could it have been a coincidence? Imagine we disassembled the whole Ferrari into a big pile. And inside this pile, you have the windscreen, you have the seats, you have the nuts and bolts, you have the engine on one side, the gearbox on another side. All of the components that makes up the Ferrari is all in one heap of a pile. How long would it take for this pile to come back together and form the Ferrari again? If we come back in 6 months, is it possible that the Ferrari will build itself? How about 1,000 years? How about 1,000,000 years? In 1,000,000 years, would that Ferrari build itself just coincidentally out of nothing? You and I, we all know that is impossible. Even 1,000,000,000 years is still an impossibility. So we can say this, that the car was designed, it was engineered, manufactured, it was assembled. It takes intelligence, it takes wisdom, it takes artistry to put something together like this. So there is someone who made this. Just like we analyzed the Ferrari, now let's analyze something so much more complex and so much more intricate than that, and that is our own selves. Let's analyze ourselves. Look at our eyes. Just like the example in the windscreen was perfectly placed in the car, your eyes are perfectly placed in its position. You can see millions of shapes, forms, colors. You can differentiate between your child and your mother. And not only that, but we are very unique that your eyes are not just designed for seeing, but it's connected to your emotions, fear, love. What you see, it affects your emotions. Look at the way in which your nose is designed to be able to smell the difference between a flower and the difference in smelling the beautiful foods. Your ears are designed so perfect also. We can differentiate between different voices and volumes and frequencies. Did you know that the balance of our body is reliant on our ears? Then think about your taste buds. It's able to understand the difference between something that's sweet or sour or bitter. If something tastes nice, if something is bad for you, your taste buds tells you. How about our digestive system? You eat something, it starts to digest. It breaks up into particles and elements, and it goes to the places where it needs it most. For example, your bones need calcium. So your digestive system gets the things out of the food that has calcium and sends it to the bones. If there was the slightest mistake in the digestive system. For example, the calcium that's supposed to go to your bones, it went into your brain instead. Your head will become stone.
Seriously?
We could go on and on and on for hours and hours describing every single part of the human body and the engineering, the architecture, the artistry, the wisdom behind its creation. And then we can talk about the emotional aspect of the being, the spiritual aspect of the being. It won't stop. Finally, what I want to say in all of this is it cannot be a coincidence.
At least we can agree to this. We said that the car was designed, it was engineered, manufactured, assembled, and put together by an intelligent being. Then when we look at our own selves, do you really believe that this human being came into existence just out of coincidence?
This perfect design, this perfect engineering, artistry, wisdom behind the way in which it's been created, the perfection of its being.
Could all of this also have been a coincidence? Seriously? It's impossible. It's impossible that there is no designer. It's impossible that there is no engineer. It's impossible that it was not created by an intelligent being. It's impossible that all of this was put together and it's just a coincidence. It's impossible.